All right. What's up, everybody? All my people in Manhattan, the Bronx, Queens, all of Staten Island, my homeborough, Brooklyn. I'm back at it with another video. And this is going to be another entry to the Greatest of All Time series, my Super Bowl week edition. Of course, Super Bowl is next Sunday. You know, it's coming up. Of course, the hype Super Bowl week is probably the most exciting time in sports to me. I told you guys I did a video announcement. I'm going to be doing Greatest of All Time editions and do it on Super Bowl teams. It's going to be on the first one, the 2000 Baltimore Ravens, who are, to me, the greatest defense to ever play in the history of the NFL. Okay, I know that's kind of sacrilegious because the 70s Steelers and the 85 Bears, the late 80s, early 90s Giants, by the way, they're kind of underrated. They, you know, Lawrence Taylor, Carl Banks, Terry Carson. I'll get to them when I get to that video. But 2000 Ravens, man, you know, they're probably the best defense of the last 20, 25, 30 years, you know. You know, the rules changing, you know, they just dominated. Okay, of course, led by Hall of Famer right here, Ray Lewis. That's a cornerback, James Trapp, and tight end Shannon Sharp. So the Baltimore Ravens gave up the fewest points in an NFL season in a 16-game season. They gave up 165 points, excuse me. And according to Shannon Sharp, they had two interceptions. The Ravens offense had two pick sixes, you know, interception, return, touchdown, that went on their total. So really, you know, 165, so that's what? Like over 150, 140 points? This defense was just dominant, man. They went 12-4. They went 12-4. And you know what the most amazing thing about the 2000 Baltimore Ravens is there was a stretch of five games where they didn't score a touchdown and they won two of the games with their kicker, Money Matt Stover. And that defense just helped punish the offense. Of course, you know, they went on a three-game losing streak. They benched their starting quarterback at that time, Tony Banks, and replaced him with Trent Dilfer, who was the quarterback for the Tampa Bay Buccaneers in the mid-late 90s when they had their defense with Sapp and Brooks. So I'm going to get to them in their video. And they ran the table. I think they finished the season like 7-0 or 7-1, something like that. Went 12-4. Now back then, you know, the NFL was different. There were three divisions. There was the AFC South, the AFC Central, the AFC East, and the AFC West. The Baltimore Ravens played in the AFC Central, you know, which was, them, the Pittsburgh Steelers, the Cleveland Browns, Cincinnati Bengals. But you also had the Tennessee Titans and the Jacksonville Jaguars, who, of course, now play in the AFC South with the Colts and the Texans. Back then, the Colts were in the AFC East with the Patriots and Jets in them, and the Texans weren't exist. The Texans didn't come into existence until 2002. But anyway, I said, let's say this. Baltimore didn't win their division. The Tennessee Titans did, 13-3, you know. They played a wild card game at home against Denver, the Denver Broncos, Shannon Sharp's former team, and Shannon caught a touchdown, and they won the game like 17-6 or something like that. They only allowed two field goals. They played the Titans, and the Titans were the only team scoring an offensive touchdown on the Baltimore Ravens that postseason. Of course, it was cemented when Ray Lewis, we all know the iconic image of Steve McNair, God bless his soul, throwing to Eddie George, and Ray Lewis just wrestling the ball out of his hands. Eddie grabbing onto Ray's ankle, Ray snatching it back and taking it 50 yards to the house to ice the game 24-10 and beat the Tennessee Titans in their stadium. At the time, it was called Adelphia Coliseum. And by the way, they played Tennessee in that regular season, and the Titans were undefeated in that new stadium. They were undefeated. They hadn't lost a game. And the Ravens came in and just beat them. And then they beat them in the playoffs. And the AFC Championship game, they went to play the Oakland Raiders. Oakland Raiders with Rich Gannon and young Charles Woodson and older Timmy Brown and John Gruden, and just beat the living shit out of them. There was a play where the mammoth defensive tackle, Tony Siragusa, for the Ravens, he hit Rich Gannon, and he's like 300 pounds. Siragusa isn't, just landed in his midsection, knocked him out of the game. Shannon Sharp did what he normally does, caught a pass, made a touchdown, and that was it. All the Ravens had to do was score one touchdown, get the lead, and then it was over. They won that game 16-3, and of course, they mollywopped my New York Giants in the Super Bowl 34-7. And the only touchdown we got was a kickoff return with the receiver Ron Dixon returning it. And then the Ravens returned the favor with Jermaine Lewis, who was their punt returner that year. He lost his son, his baby son, earlier that year, and was playing for him. He returned a touchdown, which iced the game, 31-7. Then they kicked another field goal, being 34-37, and it was over. Now, you see the statistics. They were ranked 14th at offense, first in defense. One in defense, you know, This is their schedule. Play Pittsburgh, play Jacksonville. Gave up 36 points, unfortunately. You know, Jimmy Smith, the wide receiver for the Jaguars, had a legendary game. That's why people say he should be in the Hall of Fame, because he had a great game against the 2000 Ravens. You know, played Miami, lost, but played the Bengals, played the Browns. Look at him. Shut out the Bengals, 37-0. Shut out the Browns, 12-0. This was, at this point, this is when the no touchdown streak started. Beat the Jaguars 15-10, lost to the Redskins 3-10, lost to the Titans 6-14, lost to Pittsburgh 6-9. Beat Cincinnati 27-7, beat Tennessee 24-23. Beat the Cowboys, shut out the Cowboys. Molly Wops, Cleveland, they had four shutouts. Week one against Pittsburgh, week four against Cincinnati, week five against Cleveland, and week 12 against Dallas. They had four shutouts. And the record for most shutouts in the season is held by the 1976 Pittsburgh Steelers, who didn't win the Super Bowl. And then you see the scores. Oh, I'm sorry, I got the scores wrong. It's 21-3 Denver, 24-10 Tennessee, and then 16-3 Raiders. But yeah, the 2000 Baltimore Ravens, they're, to me, the greatest defense of all time. Now, granted, now how I rank all-time great defenses and teams is, all-time great teams is number of Hall of Famers. Of course, you had to win the Super Bowl, your number of Hall of Famers, and your record, your regular season record. You know, that's how I rank. You know, the 2000 Baltimore Ravens had about four Hall of Famers. You know, Jonathan Ogden, the left tackle, Shannon Sharp, Rod Woodson, and Ray Lewis. Those are four. That's four. Okay. They had four Hall of Famers, and this is the receiver Brandon Stokely catching the touchdown in the Super Bowl, which gave the Ravens an early lead. This is Jermaine Lewis icing the game with his 84-yard punt return or kickoff return for a touchdown. Yeah, man. So are the Ravens the greatest team of all time? No. But they're definitely the greatest defense of all time. Better than the 02 Bucks. No disrespect to them, because they're great too. If someone told me the 2002 Bucks were better than the 2000 Ravens, you know, I wouldn't agree. But, you know, I could see where you're coming from. But like I said, I'm going to get to them in a minute. Better than the 13 Seahawks. Better than the, you know, 15 Broncos. But, yeah, man, what do you think? Are the 2000 Ravens the greatest defense of all time? If you agree, comment down below. If you don't agree, comment down below. Like the video if you liked it. Subscribe, help a young brother grow on YouTube. And, you know, count down to the Super Bowl, all right? See you all.